तत्परम्पर्याय विद्महे ज्ञानलिङ्गेश्वराय धीमहि तन्नो गुरुः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ योगमहर्षि डॉक्टर स्वामी गीतानन्दगिरि गुरु महाराज की जय। ॐ पुदुवाय कलमामणि पुदुवाय शक्ति योगचारिणी अम्माजी मीनाक्षी देवी भवनानी गुरुमाता की जय। ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ। नमस्ते, दिस इज संगीता। ग्रीटिंग्स एवरीवन। We are going to practice all of the practices of the Gitananda Nada Yoga that we have been studying and focusing on during the first two modules of our online immersion. So we will begin with Mukhabhastrika. So please make yourselves at ease in the Vajrasana, facing north. We'll do three rounds. Inhaling, Kaki Mudra. Inhale. Inhale. We remain in the Dharmikasana for a few breaths. Inhale, chin up. And just to compensate, you can bring your hands behind you, going back with the right and then with the left, opening up. From here, stretch your legs in front of you, bend your knees. Roll your feet. Shake your head. Inhaling Dandasana, forward to Paschimottanasana, bounce a bit. Clasp your hands behind your neck. Clasp the hands behind your back. Come on up. Your knees again, shake your head. Opening at the hip. You can catch hold of your foot. Open. Meanwhile, breathe. That's good. That would be very good if you breathed. And then catch hold of your inner part of the foot if you can, and whether you can actually stretch your leg or keep it bent, it's okay. Just open at the hip a bit more. And then move your knee, warming up the knee. From here, inhale, squeeze in, release. Again, inhale. One more time. Inhaling, going up and forward again, we repeat. regularity, rhythm, repetition. Relax your lips, your eye muscles. Clasp the hands behind the neck, elongate the spine. Relax the jaw muscles, lips. Clasp the hands behind the back. Relax your hands. Shake your hands. Thump the feet. Thump the knees. Shake your head. Moving on to the next leg, the left leg. Catching hold of the leg. Then bending, warming up the knee. Inhaling, squeezing in. Inhale. And one more time. Moving forward. Clasp the hands behind your neck, lower the shoulders, stretch your back. And then clasp the hands behind the back. Good. Shake your head. Roll the feet again. Catch hold of the right leg. And place the foot mid-thigh so you can open the opposite, you can open the right hip by doing this very gentle bounce. Very good. Just relax that and then we'll do the other side. Relax that, and then we'll come into the Baddha Kona and open. Breathe and relax. And now all of these can be modified. You know this already, so try to warm up the body without hurting the body. And from here, you can come forward with a straight back if possible. And then you can bring your feet a little bit further away from the rest of the torso and then come down and see where you can reach by stretching the body gently. If you're able to, and if you feel inclined, you can bring your hands under the feet and attempt to bring your head towards your feet. Kurmasana. From here, inhale, bring your knees together. You can bounce them again a bit. Shake your head. Now the jatis of the upper part of the body, the upper limbs, shaking your hands. Roll your hands. Roll your elbows. And then see if you can roll your shoulders. And forward. Continue to breathe evenly. And then we're going to roll the boat down. And then roll the boat back. Exhale as you come down. Inhale as you come up. and relax. And then come to the Vajrasana. In the Vajrasana, make sure the heels are together so that they stimulate the Vajrini Nadi, the Vajra Nadi. And notice how your body is sitting in this posture and what types of adjustments you need to make to feel yourself at ease in this posture, the diamond posture of valor and strength. Now from here, we're going to roll our heads a couple of times. Try not to pinch the back vertebrae. Therefore, maintain an elongated, relaxed neck and use your breath to guide you. Try not to hold your breath, particularly if you have some trauma in this area. There may be a tendency to hold the breath as you roll. Relax your face completely if you can. Lips, eyes, cheeks. Good, and then you can roll the head from side to side. And to stimulate our lungs, we're going to bring our left hand to the ground, and just on an in-breath, lift your arm and then stretch the right side of the body with the right area of the lungs. Relax your face and lips. And then on an exhale, bring the body back. And then on an inhale, lift your arm. On an exhale, lower it. And then stay here and breathe a few times and stretch. Inhale, come up. Exhale, come down. In module one, we have practiced the Soham Mantra, Shabda Pratyahara, and Brahmari Pranayama. So what we will do here is that we will go in the sequence of opening to a deep level of listening with the Shabda Pratyahara. Then as we bring our awareness to the sound of our breath, we are going to practice the Soham Mantra, and then the Brahmari Pranayama. Then we will take a short pause to stretch our body and go into the Vibhaga Pranayama, Pranava Pranayama. So you're welcome to stay in the Vajrasana. If the Vajrasana is uncomfortable, you may come into a cross-legged position. Make sure that your spine maintains an alignment. So if you know that you're going to slowly fall back, you can prop yourself on some cushions or blankets. You may also do this on a chair. If you're doing this on a chair, however, and if you can, please come to the edge of the chair and maintain your position aligned. Do not recline back. If you have to recline back, make sure your body is aligned with your head to the north and make sure that your body can be as relaxed as possible. This is also true if you have to lie down. So let's begin. And begin by bringing your sense of hearing under the control of your mind. and listen to the inner sounds of your body. Particularly the sound of your heartbeat or the sensation of your heart beating. And the flushing of the blood in the veins and the arteries. Also listen to any other sounds occurring in your body, inside of your body, perhaps from the digestive system or the breathing system, respiratory system. Then move right outside of your body to the sounds that are immediately around your head. Swamiji tells us that there's often a very high-pitched sound just outside of our ears that can be perceived. See if you can hear and then listen to it. Try to remain relaxed. And not to grab, not to search. Just allow the sounds to come to your awareness. Relax. As you relax your breath and slowly make it more regular and deep, your sense of listening will also become deeper. So observe the relationship between deep breathing and deep listening. The more relaxed we are, better we can listen. Now allow your sense of hearing, as you listen intently, to move to your immediate environment, the room you're in, or if you're in the open, just the area around you, perhaps about 50 meters around you. And then stretch your capacity to listen to about 100 meters, the size of a city block. Listen all around you. Front, the sides, the back, above and below. Stay open. Continue breathing regularly and intentionally to maintain your focus and energy and try not to slouch or become lazy. Stay alert and relaxed. And now stretch your sense of hearing under the control of your mind to the size of a city around you. Three, 4 miles around you. And then stretch your listening as far as you can, in all directions. And then imagine that you can listen beyond the earthly atmosphere into the solar system and beyond. Try not to grab. Stay relaxed. And then slowly come back onto this earthly plane and listen to, as far as you can, any sound that you can listen to. And then withdrawing your sense of listening to about 4 or 5 miles around you, or about 7-8 kilometers around you. And then withdrawing a little more to about a city block around you. And then slowly and progressively coming back to an environment that is about 50 meters around you. And then your immediate environment. And then just the space around your body. Space around your head. And then traveling back inwards, inside of your body. The heart beating, the breath inhaling, exhaling, and any other sound that is there. And then focusing now on your breath, entering and entering and entering and entering the body through the nostrils. And then exiting and exiting and exiting the body through the nostrils. Deep inhales and exhales, seamless, even, relaxed. And listening deeply to the sound of the breath. This acoustic essence of the prana that through the breath we bring into our own body and we release on the exhale. Connecting us to all that is and connecting all that is to us. Listening first to the inner sound of sa as you inhale. And aham as you exhale. Without a need to actually making the sound yourself. But by refining your sense of hearing to hear the mantra that is already there, the ajapa japa. Inhaling sa, exhaling ham. Inhaling, connecting with the greatest source of all that is. Exhaling, sharing who you are, right here and now, with all that is. There is no sa without hum. There is no hum without sa. All that is manifests through me, and I embody all that is and express it creatively. You may now make the sound a little bit more audible. and gentle again. Bring the hands in the Namaskara Mudra. And then bring your hands in the Yoni Mudra. Thumb in the ears, forefinger and middle finger in the eyes, ring finger on the nostrils, small finger in between the lips. We will do 9 rounds of Brahmari. You may not be able to hear my own counts, so please do 9 rounds and then we will meet again here.
Thank you.
And observe and listen. Then you can slowly open your eyes. Come out of the Vajrasana. Dump your legs and relax for a moment. Take a moment to connect with your body and stretch the body in any way that feels appropriate. We are now going to practice the Vibhaga Pranayama. So come back into the Vajrasana. Beginning with Adham Pranayama, lower sectional breathing, with the Sparsha Mudras. Bring your hands in the lower section of your lungs, the front subsection. We will do a 6x6 ratio. Exhale. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Moving to the sides of Adham Pranayama. Exhale to prepare. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale. Moving to the back of Adham Pranayama, exhale to prepare. Inhale, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Relax for a moment. Now bringing the three areas together, the three subsections together of Adham Pranayama, using the hands, inhaling 2, 2, 2, exhaling 2, 2, 2. Ready? Exhale to prepare. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Moving on to Madhyam Pranayama, the pectoral area, middle area of the lungs, front section. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Moving to the sides right away. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And then turning the heads, hands with the fingers towards the spine, exhaling to prepare. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And then relax your hands for a moment in your arms. Three rounds of the full breath of the Madhyam area, 2, 2, and 2. Exhale to prepare. Inhale, 1, 2, side, 2, back, 2. Exhale back, 1, 2, side, 1, 2, front, 1, 2. Again, inhale. Exhale back. Inhale. Exhale. Now you may relax the Vajrasana if you're in Vajrasana. And stay focused on the sensation of prana flowing in your body, just inside of the body or just on the outside of your physical anamaya kosha, physical, physiological. Come back to Vajrasana. Moving now up to the Adhyam Pranayama. Clavicular area. Adhyam, Adhyam. Front side of Adhyam Pranayama. Then the side and then the back. 6x6. Exhale to prepare. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Bring your hands on your thighs so that you may open this area and feel the upper side of the lungs inhaling and exhaling 6x6. Exhale to prepare. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. In. Out. Very good. Now bring the hands to touch the upper area of the lungs in the back. Try to relax your shoulders as best as you can and your neck. Exhale to prepare. Inhale. Out. In. Out. In. Out. And relax. And now we will do three rounds, just imagining the movement. Front, side, back as I inhale, and back, side, front as I exhale. I will not be using the hands as it is a bit much of a movement. So you can bring your hands out here as we did for the side, and just imagine with your mind, bring your mind in those areas, focus in those areas. So exhale to prepare. Inhale, front. Side, back, exhale, back, side, front, inhale, exhale. exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Very good. Relax your legs for just a couple of breaths. We will now move directly to the Vibhaga Pranayama with the Hasta Mudras and the Akara, Ukara, Mukara, Makara sounds. So we're transitioning from the Vibhaga directly into the Pranava Pranayama with the Hasta Mudras. We will do a 1-by-3 ratio. Inhaling 6, exhaling 18. Come back to the Vajrasana. So, as a reminder, when we inhale 6 for the full subsection of that section. So, when we work with the Akara Nada and we work with the Adham Pranayama, we inhale 2, 2, 2, and we exhale 6, 6, 6 with the Nada. Okay? So we will do the three sections, one after the other, and then we will do the Mahat Yoga Pranayama. Chin Mudra. Exhale to prepare. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. For a moment. Chinmaya Mudra. Madhyam Pranayama. Exhale to prepare. Inhale. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Ooh. Adi Mudra. Exhale. Adhyam Pranayama. Inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale. Inhale. Yoga Pranayama, Brahma Mudra. So here again we inhale 6 by inhaling 2 in the Adham, 2 in the Madhyam, 2 in the Adhyam, so it's fairly fast, and then 6 the full Adham, 6 the full Madhyam, 6 the full Adhyam, 18. Aum. Exhale to prepare. Inhaling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Three more. Inhale. Oh. And now you may come down to the Shavasana with the head to the north. And if you need in the passage to again thump your legs, roll your head, you're welcome to do so. We will now practice the Kaya Kriya. And as a experimentation in this Nada Yoga immersion, we will add the pranava to the Kaya Kriya, which is not traditionally taught. But we are in a testing phase, in an experimentation phase. So we will test it. So as you lay down, for the Kaya Kriya, you'll need to bring your arm, your legs parted a bit, so that you can make sure that when you bring your legs inwards, the toes are touching, or at least are as close as possible. So we will do the Kaya Kriya in the three parts. Sorry. And then we will bring them all together. So what we will do is that when we inhale, we are going to use a 6-count inhale, focusing on the Adam Pranayama, if you could. Bring your mind there. As you exhale, 18. Okay? All right. Exhale to prepare. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the legs rolled in on the inhale. Now the arms are going to roll out on the inhale. Okay? Exhale to prepare. Matyam Pranayama. Inhale 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ooh. witness what is occurring in your different bodies without identification or justification. And then for the Adhyam Pranayama, we're inhaling six with our head to the right. And we're exhaling 18, bringing the head back to the left. Okay? So from the center, exhale to prepare. Inhale six to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. To the center and relax and observe. Fully let go. Now we will bring it all together. So we will be inhaling in each section for two counts. So feet come in. I'll just tell once before we begin, just to review it. Inhaling Adham, feet come in. Inhaling Madhyam, arms go out. Inhaling Adhyam, head goes to the right. Exhaling Adham, six, the feet come out. Everything else stays the same. Exhaling Madhyam, six, arms come in. The head stays the same. And exhaling Adhyam, the head comes to the left. And that is with the Nadam. Let's try it. We'll do three rounds, okay? Inhaling 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bring your feet together, arms by your side, just rest in Shavasana. You may stay longer here in Shavasana. Otherwise, lift your left arm over the head. Then roll on your left flank with the right side dominant in a Nishpandasana or half a fetal position. You're letting your nervous system know that you're going to become more active, come back to more activity as you're stimulating the Surya Nadi corresponding to the right side of the physical body. And from here, we're going to come into the Umukhasana, the face prone position. And relax. Then activate the legs and the buttocks. Bring your hands by the shoulders. Exhale. On your inhale, from the bottom of the spine, come up into the Bhujangasana, looking up. Then coming down into the Shashangasana. And relax here. And then slowly lift into Vajrasana. We'll conclude this practice with the Lokasana Stana.
Loka Samastha. sukhinu bhavantu sarve janah sukhinu bhavantu om shanti shanti shanti.
Thank you. We thank all of the gurus of the parampara of Yoga Maharishi Dr. Swami Gitananda Giri, our beloved Amaji, our beloved Acharya Dr. Ananda Balayogi Bhavanani, the whole Bhavanani family. Hari Om Tat Sat.